Yo, what's going on, Celestia Town? Welcome back to a brand new video on my channel, you guys. In today's video, we're going to be reacting to exposing things you've been doing wrong every day on Facebook's channel. If you guys are new to the channel, be sure to give a like, subscribe if you're new, share the video, comment in the comment section down below. We are back with more Facebook. So, we're going to jump right in it, guys. We're going to record in 3, 2, 1, record. I hope you guys have a great day. So, let's jump in it, bro. Love these types of videos.
You have been doing things wrong your entire life. Like that guy over there.
That's not how you dip your Oreo in the milk.
What do you mean, bro? Look, it's fully covered.
That is not the right way to do it. So you take a fork and you stick it in the middle of the Oreo.
Oh.
Pull it out.
That's crazy.
And now you have an easier way of dipping your
Oreo.
Bro,
wait, hold
on. That's crazy, bro. Okay, that's very cool, you know? It's been a while since I've had Oreos, but all this time, bro, I've been having Oreos, like, without a fork. But this really teaches something else, bro. You stick your Oreo, like, the fork, like, where the cream is, and then you dip it in the milk. That's so much easier than dipping it in the milk with your hand, bro. So much easier, bro.
That's so cool. One of those, and you just...
It's actually more...
Hey, bro!
No!
What?
No!
What is wrong with you?
I put the whole thing in.
As long as you're not like this guy, you should be good. Did you know
that? Oh my gosh, Noah. Noah's comedy. I can't with Noah, bro. Literally dipped his whole hand, along with the Oreo, along with the fork, everything in the freaking milk, and... Oh my god.
Salt to it and it'll take it away.
Pardon?
You should be good. Did you know that if your coffee is bitter, you can add salt to it and it'll take it away?
I want this a refresher. Was...
Well, that's not happening.
All right.
Okay, listen, I'll get the coffee for
salt?
Later and get a refresher.
To take the bitterness away?
Do you guys have salt packets on the side that I could add?
How many do you need, man? I got like 7 on me right now.
Let's
seven.
Run the 7. That's fine. Hey, I appreciate that.
Or
you
okay.
Always be making it the best. I'm not gonna lie.
That looks
my
fire.
Name is
Faz.
Faz. Rug.
Faz Rug.
That's so good.
Tastes like me?
It does.
Oh, all right, here we go. So we're going to try this.
Really bitter.
We're going to do all of them, bro. Hey, you want to help me out? Oh, you got salt on you too.
Obviously.
Oh, okay.
Yo, their shorts are fire. I love the design.
Around. I have like the Himalayan.
Wait, hold on.
Himalayan salt?
Let's see if there's actually a taste difference.
Yeah. No, right?
No.
Let me see. I want to do this one.
Ooh. It's like too salty now.
Yeah.
I made it worse.
Keep drinking your coffee normal.
You guys have been doing it right.
Yeah, bro. I could not. Okay, that one is very interesting. I had a hunch that would not have worked. I had a hunch, bro. I had a hunch. Again, this video was out 8 months ago. So this is kind of like going to be a refresher for me to watch again.
To you, every single person out there watching has been using this air freshener wrong.
How so?
You take it out and then you just open the whole thing.
I've never heard of this one.
And you put it up.
Never heard of this air freshener.
Incorrect. How? This is the craziest thing ever, but these are actually supposed to last you 6 months if
wow.
You do it properly.
6 months?
Six months is a long time.
See these two black lines right here?
Yep.
This is important. So you're going to cut it just like that.
Okay.
And then do the other side. So you open it up, take it out. See how it's like pulled out a little bit, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is how you're supposed to do it.
Oh.
Look at this, guys. I know it looks ugly.
That's
but
cool,
the real
though.
Way and how they explain it in the directions is like that. So right
wow.
Now, it smells really strong. Every 2 weeks, you're supposed to pull this down a little more, just like
wow.
That. And it's supposed to last you 6 months.
That's insane. Usually, these last
that's...
like maybe a week or two.
Seriously.
Because you use all the smell right away, bro.
The difference from 2 weeks... Is that what Noah said?
It's insane. Usually, these last like maybe a week or two.
A week or two. A week or two, the time difference from a week or two to 6 months, that fam, you're saving that air freshener.
Big time. All the smell right
that's
away.
So cool.
Bro, it has it like this.
Oh my gosh, I have one. This has been in my car for like 2 years. I didn't even realize it was.
That's crazy.
I haven't been to a park in so long. How upgraded is
it? Right, wait, do something.
Oh.
Fam.
But there is something that you guys probably didn't know.
I love how
they're
kids at heart, bro. I love it.
I saw this, I was mind blown. Did you ever know how to go down one of these slides? This is a slide. I thought it was just so you could climb up to get to the top, right? There's a specific way to go down that where you...
I have never even tried. I haven't ever, as a kid, I don't recall ever going down those slides. Something like that.
Go pretty fast.
You can tell he's been doing it wrong his whole life.
Nice to meet you.
I've been watching the videos for so long.
Thank you.
Yo,
do you guys
fan
know
love.
How to use this or no?
This one is messed up. So this is supposed to be in the middle.
That's what I thought.
Yeah.
So they just built it wrong?
Yeah, they built it wrong.
Oh,
yeah, I guess
well,
you can't do it.
Well, that's a fail. Dang, that's unfortunate.
It wasn't our fault.
It wasn't.
It wasn't their fault.
A classic staple inside everyone's home. This is big.
I mean, everyone makes mistakes, bro. Like, they just
constructed it wrong, you know?
Sometimes you want to travel with something a little bit bigger, and maybe you don't have the time to go get another bag. Pull another one of those out.
Okay.
And what I want you to do is to flip it inside out.
Okay, so flip this.
Inside out.
Inside out.
Okay.
What you're going to do now is you're actually going to place that bag inside of this one. And you're going to line it up with the lining of the Ziploc
okay.
bag. Oh, and it locks in? And it locks in.
What?
Place
Bro.
It inside of here. I hear it clicking. So once you have it all the way lined up, you kind of crease it down a little bit more to make sure it's fully secure. Boom. Damn.
No flipping way.
I didn't know that was a thing.
Now you do.
There you go.
That's cool. So happy cool, now. Though.
Did you guys
That's
know
cool.
that Tic-Tacs?
That's cool, bro. We have so many Ziploc bags. I would not even have guessed you could actually do that. That's actually really cool.
Have a special dispenser that if you want to give your friend
oh, this was cool. This
tic-tac,
was cool.
It's used for that. When you want to be greedy, you're going down
Someone...
to the last few ones. You don't want to get
like, look at this. You see this? Obviously,
yeah.
regular Tic Tacs. No, you want some?
Yeah.
That's Thanks. Too much for you. You guys
yeah.
see this right here? It was made to just dispense one at a time. Look at this. So you close it, flip
right.
it upside down.
Upside down. Yeah. Oh Ooh, my gosh.
Green. You can only have one.
Oh.
Wait, that's actually sick.
One Tic Tac.
And it just looks cool. You could use these to flex on your friends.
They would think you're
yeah.
so much cooler.
And don't tell them you saw this video. Just say that you knew this.
Yeah, because
you're
him or her.
Yo, what? I've had Tic Tacs so many times as a kid. All that time, I could not have guessed the freaking dispenser. That little cap is used for that, bro. All that. Oh my gosh, that could have been so beneficial for me. Jeez, bro, that's cool.
Grab our soda so we can head out.
That was a cool one.
Bro.
Yo.
Not a real soda.
Says who?
It's the out of order.
Out of order.
Another party trick here that you guys probably didn't know. If you guys grab two sodas from the gas station,
uh-huh.
you can actually use a plastic bag as a cup holder. You just have to do it when I'm
That's cool.
Huh?
That's cool.
Do you know about that cup holder party trick with the plastic bag?
I've seen it. I have seen it.
If I think you put one
in
down.
One corner, then you
wow.
the bag, I think.
Oh.
You're going to put the other
hey,
one.
Hey, W worker. She saw the TikTok.
And that's it?
And that's it.
No
There's your cup holder.
Bro.
That's fire.
That's fire.
The durability of these cup holders. Bro.
Oh,
come on, G.
That's crazy. The drinks still go flying out.
Confess.
That's wow.
perfect. Favorite one so far.
Wow.
Did you know that you've been drinking water wrong your whole life? If you're anything like me, you hate the taste of plain water, which is why I've been using Air Up.
Air Up.
So Air Up is a water bottle that actually
yeah, this is
creates
really cool.
flavor through scent.
That's actually crazy. They don't use any preservatives, nothing. That's really cool, bro. That's really cool. I would love to try Air Up one of these days. I don't mind the taste of water, but I would love to try Air Up for sure.
I know, it sounds cool, right? Let
That's
me show you
cool.
how it works. They have so many flavors to choose from, but my personal favorite is watermelon.
Ooh, watermelon.
So this is what they look like.
Oh, I love
so
watermelon.
Good. So you're gonna pop it open, just like that.
Right.
You take the pod out, you
right.
pop it over the top,
uh-huh.
and when you pull it up, you take a sip. It literally tastes like watermelon,
that's,
but you're just drinking regular water.
That's crazy.
The main thing I love about Air Up
that's
is that
crazy.
It actually motivates me to drink water every single day.
I love
I
that.
I literally had a problem with it before where I would drink like one water bottle a day, but
I feel
refill
you.
This
I feel
at
you.
Least six times a day.
That's
I'm sure
great.
You guys are all curious to try this out for yourselves and see how it works. So
I love
I'm
going
to be giving you guys 15% off.
You're literally
if you
drinking
use code RUG at checkout.
Regular
Click
water.
The link in the description.
With
Bro,
air.
No.
You're drinking regular water with freaking. It's like you're drinking regular water, but like you taste watermelon or you taste peach or you taste whatever flavor it is, bro. It's really cool.
Way you have bubbles.
Blowing
right
bubbles
now. You know
the wrong
I
way.
Love those. And I can guarantee you've been using this wrong your whole life. Show me how you do it.
Okay.
And let me show you how you're really supposed to use these bubble ones.
Oh, yo.
What the frick?
Just gotta do good with the motion. You
That's
know what I mean?
Sick.
There you go. It's supposed to do it faster.
That's
right?
a crazy
Wait, that's
one.
Really fast.
It's fast, bro. You're like turning
Yo.
Into a bubble machine. One of the worst things ever.
That's crazy. All the time I've been blowing the bubble. Bro, this is teaching me a lot of stuff, bro. I haven't done bubble blowing in so long, but that's sick as heck.
And trying to
You've been taking off tape the wrong
off
way.
The tape, but you rip the paper.
Oh, it's so annoying.
So there's a certain way you can take the tape off where it won't rip the paper.
Really? Oh.
Yeah. Try this one right here,
okay.
how you would normally do it.
Oh, no.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It took the whole like away. But if
yeah.
we can successfully take this tape off with subscribe written on this paper
subscribe
after,
to
you cannot subscribe. Can you hold that side, please?
I can, yeah.
And then we'll take this side
See.
Off. So you just pull it like that. Okay. And now,
what?
You can see it slowly coming off. If you want to just keep doing it.
No
okay,
way.
We're almost there. And then hold on, I'm going to slowly take this off now.
That's satisfying as
no
heck, bro.
Way.
Oh my gosh.
Wait, that's perfect.
You just stretched the tape. I would have never guessed
same.
That.
Same,
this is one of
same.
My favorite ones.
Same.
To the camera. That's you hold your burger like this.
That's true. Bro, do you understand how crazy that is, bro? Because there's so many times where I would want to, like, you know, tear tape off the paper and it would ruin the paper. But that really, really makes you... Oh my gosh, that's cool.
This is one of my favorite ones.
Same.
To the camera. So you hold your burger like this, right? I actually don't.
The correct way to hold your burger.
Everyone confronts me about it. I hold my burger...
Hey, In-N-Out, top tier fast food place. Their burgers are fire. Everything is fire, bro. But... The correct way to hold... Fam, I don't even know what the right way to hold the burger is, bro. I don't even care, bro. I just eat the dang In-N-Out burger, fam.
It's like this. What's the problem, bro?
That's the bottom bun.
Yeah, but what does it matter?
I guess it does.
Into your body, bro.
I guess it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter, exactly.
Your burger falls apart. That's the worst thing to happen.
Facts.
So there's a specific way you can hold your burger where it'll be very firm and nothing will fall
this
out.
Guy in the back...
So there's a specific way you can hold your burger where it'll be very...
This guy in the back, like, what are they doing?
...firm and nothing will fall out. Some people actually do this already. This is just something I learned right now. You take your pinkies and you put them at the bottom.
Really?
So you're holding it like this.
Okay.
And then you take a nice bite.
Okay. That's a bite right there.
Mm-hmm. Look at that, all in one place. If I was doing it the other way, the tomato would have fallen.
That's so true.
Is wow.
Ketchup? Yeah. You're still doing it wrong.
Okay, that's cool. Okay, that's really cool. I never would have thought that, because fam, sometimes the burgers, you know, they fall apart. It happens. But fam, again, In-N-Out, fire. If you guys don't have In-N-Out where you are, I feel so bad for you. But...
I mean, I'm doing it wrong.
Follow me. Come on.
Let's go to the ketchup stand. I wouldn't say you're necessarily doing it wrong.
Okay.
But there's a better way of putting ketchup in one of these packets to get more.
But you right. know it all.
So what you're going to want to do...
Oh, you open it up. Yeah. Right? This one I remember.
Just like that.
You open it up.
You're doing it until it gets flat.
That's crazy.
You put way more ketchup.
Yeah, more ketchup.
Room.
That's really
ketchup,
cool.
Though. You learned something?
That's actually sick. I'm still doing it my way.
Wait, my
of course.
Here. What is that, fam?
It's an onion bun burger.
Oh, Flying Dutchman.
Y'all don't do that? Like, come on now.
Flying Dutchman.
Nowadays,
bro. See, look at the pinky underneath.
Oh, so it still works.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, the green
nice.
Onions here, insane.
This one right here, bro.
Flying Dutchman looks fire. Not gonna lie, it looks really good.
Bro, absolutely mind blowing.
Tell me more.
So you know this paper towel holder right here, right? So
right.
You just have it on your kitchen table. Dude, that is the worst
bro,
sound of all
doing?
Time. So this is the normal way of doing it, right? But now,
that
see this
sad.
Part right here? You have a cabinet. I don't know if it was invented for this, but if you put it like that.
That's sick. That's crazy.
Wait, no.
See, we don't have cabinets like that, but that's really cool.
Only thing is the cabinet doesn't close all the way.
It doesn't.
Dude, I want you guys to try that. If you guys have that paper towel holder, because that's crazy.
Yeah.
Mustard bottles have locks on it. Stop.
Sick.
Locked into place.
Sick.
What? Instead of having it like that, you literally just press it all the way back and...
Because usually
wow.
you would get in the way when you're trying to dispense it.
But that's true, yeah.
Insane.
No, you like your neck pillow, right?
Huh?
It must be working wonders for your neck sleeping.
The
like
neck
that.
Pillow?
Yeah, supporting it. Really good.
But you're sleeping like this. Is that how you normally sleep on a plane, right?
Yeah, of course. You should bend over a little bit.
You're actually wearing it wrong. You're
that's
wrong.
Crazy.
Look at this.
What?
So when you
the
actually
other
lean
way.
Forward, you have support left, right, down.
No.
I feel like it's personal preference, of course, depending on how you sleep, because obviously you could still sleep like this.
Yeah, but
from what I've
the better
seen,
support.
A lot of people do this now.
Wow.
The support's perfect.
Very subtle, but it works.
It works.
I got you, bro.
That's crazy. That's crazy. You know what? All this time that I've always thought you could... I mean, I never thought to use the, you know, the neck... what do they call it? The neck pillow the other way? But that's really cool. Towels
the
wrong way.
Around your waist like this, right? Sometimes it might not be tight enough and it'll easily come apart. There's a new way of doing it that I just found out. You put it around your waist and instead of...
I love those bear bricks, by the way. They look so cool.
In on the inside, you can literally just roll the towel and the more
really?
You roll it, the tighter it gets. Oh my god.
Okay.
This actually feels good. It actually looks better too. Like,
that's crazy.
In almost every single car made, if you're about to go put gas, and sometimes I forget which side my gas tank is on, but in most of the cars, if you look at your dashboard, you'll see a gas tank symbol and it'll have
really?
A little arrow either pointed to the right or left, and that's to tell you where your gas tank is.
So you're
that's
already holding one thing.
You don't want to hold another either.
We're gonna remove the gas cap and see this little thing right there.
Uh-huh.
Everyone's car is different, but they actually have a holder.
Wait, what?
You kind of just place it right there and you're chilling.
You just blew my mind.
That's
real,
crazy.
I wonder if it's like that for all cars.
Mostly every car. My first car had it.
Sometimes
wow.
it can be a pain in the butt getting foil out like this.
You're already struggling.
Like,
yeah.
I'm really struggling, but did you know on the
did
side
you know?
Of the foil container, there's two circles right here that you could press in and it locks it into place.
Yo.
Right now,
it's not locked.
Okay.
See, this was crazy.
I'd love to.
Because this could actually be beneficial. Everyone uses aluminum foil.
Side.
All right. Whoa,
it's locked in now. Simple as that.
Yeah.
Wow.
Now it should just be a lot easier. That's
yeah, nice. This one is one I'll be using for sure.
Within like the little flaps right here.
Like they made it for that.
Wow.
Unknown fact about a stapler that 90% of the world probably didn't know, including myself.
When me.
To get to the bottom of it.
Literally,
right here.
So you guys probably didn't know that there was a little like scroll wheel there. Now,
no.
You just use a stapler.
Not at all.
Does what a stapler is supposed to do. Okay, see how close together the staples are?
Yep. Right.
If you just press this down.
Uh huh.
You pop that open, you can twist this, right? And now the stapler is gonna staple further away.
What? That's insane. Yo, that's crazy.
You got it. All right, turn it around.
Dang.
It's further apart.
No flipping way.
What's the point of that, though? What does it matter if they're close or far?
I think yeah, I don't know. Just wanna be different.
True.
I don't know the difference, to be honest with y'all. I don't know the difference with how short the staples are together or how distant they are. But still, that's crazy.
Shuck the corn, huh? Like, take it out of the husk.
Okay, shuck the corn.
I guess, okay. Another word. That's really
annoying. This is the one where they boil the corn. This is... I told my mom about this. This is really cool. So apparently you boil it and it's easier to take apart.
It's just taking a lot of your time, right?
Yeah, it is.
For sure.
Well, if you boil the corn first, it's a lot easier to shuck. It actually
nice.
Falls right out. So we're gonna take it out. We're gonna put it on here. So you cut the bottom part. Like
wow.
That. And now, bro.
Oh!
Nice.
Yo!
It came right
crazy.
Out.
Bro, this is a beautiful piece of corn.
It's corn.
It came out so easily.
It has the juice. It has the juice.
It has.
Easier way to eat your wings by separating all the chicken from the bones, so you're getting all the meat. You don't have to go like left, right, middle. I think what you do is you kind of loosen it a little.
Really?
I see.
I want to try this one because fam, I have chicken wings, not all the time, every single day, but I have chicken wings occasionally. So I want to try this hack, see if it works.
You see it coming apart.
So now I'm holding this side and this side.
Uh-huh.
Yep.
And I think you just bite down and pull.
Really?
Whoa.
Okay, that's crazy.
That one work?
Kind of.
Wait, but that actually made it easier because you can eat around it.
Wow.
No way.
He got it.
Is that all the meat?
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Oh my gosh. Wait, hold on. I got to give it another try.
Okay, that's cool.
Okay.
Yeah, it's very messy, but super effective.
Wow. By the way, Wingstop fire wings. If you guys have a Wingstop near you, definitely try it out.
My coffee lovers out there, listen up, pick it away. If you want to fill up your coffee with something other than just regular ice, because, you know, that's so normal. It's normal,
right?
And bro, when the ice
melts,
your coffee gets...
This one, the ice cubes, right? And then you, like, pour coffee on it, and then you put it in. And then I don't know.
Water down, have to... and you don't want that. So what you do is you put coffee inside of an ice tray,
okay.
And you actually make coffee ice cubes.
That's sick.
If the ice melts,
that's sick.
It's just more coffee. We're gonna make some of this right now.
Bro.
That's me. In the freezer they go. I got you.
I know you have some phase rug magic going on right when I put this in.
Yes, you do.
Without even closing it. We have some made from earlier.
Okay.
I would say just keep it in overnight.
This is the final result.
Whoa.
That's so cool.
That's magical. For the coffee.
Coffee ice cubes, literally.
No.
Let's see the transformation. And the transformation is...
Whoa. That's satisfying, bro.
When the ice touched my lip, like, you taste the coffee.
Wow.
There,
bro.
Mm-hmm. Solid.
That's
I'm
cool.
I'm sure all of you guys have been peeling your bananas wrong.
Okay,
your whole
this
life.
One. This amazed me.
How do you peel a banana wrong?
Obviously, you see the stem,
you pull it down.
That's
yeah.
What you think is right. You're supposed to actually do it this way, upside down. You pinch the bottom, and then you start peeling.
What?
This is literally how monkeys peel bananas.
Oh, that's sick.
That's how you know that's the right way of doing
it. Oh,
this looks correct, too. Shout out Donkey Kong, bro.
Donkey Kong.
Cool,
yeah, that's crazy, bro.
Peeling your orange.
So usually, when you peel an orange, it gets kind of annoying because when you're doing it, it gets a lot under your nails. So
yeah.
If you have a cut, too.
That hurts.
So
that hurts. That hurts.
You have a method.
There's a cool
that hurts
way to
bad.
Peel an orange, and I'm just excited to see if it works. So you're gonna cut one side like that.
Okay.
Cut the other side like that. So you're gonna try finding one of the seams, and you're gonna line it up with the knife and
okay.
Cut directly down the middle. So like right there. And then
I
you're
like
gonna
that.
Cut halfway down.
Ooh.
Look at that. Do what you want with it. I like
my that was so good. Cool. I love because, oranges.
Like, if you want to share it, you can just kind of pull it apart and just like hand it to your friends now.
Look at that.
Awesome.
That's perfect, bro.
All right, Noah, strain the pasta. All right, stop. That's wrong.
How's that wrong, bro?
Let me show you. Put the strainer on the top.
Okay.
Oh, this is cool.
It all stays in the pot.
All stays in the pot. Just an easier way so you don't have to like dump it back.
That's good.
You that's so that cool. I have a lot of pasta. That will definitely come in handy. I will definitely be using that.
The easy one that I would have never thought of.
So. Oh, yeah.
We got some Chinese takeout. Let's just eat it the right
by the
way,
fun fact, I love pasta. I'm a pasta fanatic.
Let's do it. Take off the okay. sides, right?
Yeah. First. Panda Express, in these boxes, look. Okay, this one's interesting.
We got some Chinese takeout. Let's just eat it the right way. Let's do it. Take off the sides, right?
Yeah. First, like these boxes, the top, you use it as a plate.
Taking off the sides.
Wow.
Wow. That's so cool. It is clutch. Because the actual plate.
You got your plate.
Oh, Panda Express. It's all fire. The chow mein, the fried rice, orange chicken. Oof. That looks fire. Really good.
Ice cream is rock solid, and you have to sit there and wait for 10 minutes, wait for it to get soft, and you're just so hungry. You want that ice cream, so you just start going crazy, right?
Yeah.
Simple things. Hot water, dip this in here, let it get warm, and now,
look at how smooth that was.
And you get fresh ice cream.
That's sick. That's sick.
Butter.
Smooth like butter. I'll definitely be using that, bro.
Okay, I got you.
It works.
It works at least.
Wow.
Jason Tatum, you might have to make a part two.
Noah. I mean, sorry, not Noah, but bro, when I have ice cream, I'm going to use that trick next time, bro. I promise you. I'm going to get warm water, hot water, and just...
on how to tie a tie, because we just found a way to do it in 10 seconds. Literally.
Get on, okay.
It's legit. All right, Noah, I need your help. I know this looks weird, right? 1, 2,
okay.
3. Now you're going to go in from under here and grab this second one and pull it.
Wow.
Look at that, man. Got it? Boom. Just okay. Like that, bro. Take notes, Jason.
Take notes, Tatum.
Yeah. Can I come in?
Yeah.
How's it going?
Not good, bro.
Oh, you brought it?
Yep.
You do.
Oh, this is cool. We're sorry for the TMI. If you're constipated, you get a stool, put your feet on it, and it helps the transition, let's just say. Okay?
By just having your feet on the ground.
I do. I needed this. If you put your feet on that stool, it's a healthier way to go number two.
It lets it out actually like way easier.
That's
and
cool.
Like it clears yourself out really fast.
Yeah, the bowel movement is way better with your feet increased like that.
That's
I'm
so
actually
good.
Use that all the time.
Bro, it's a new position.
So now that we have our pasta ready to go, we want to add some cheese to it. We need that.
Yeah, you've got to add that Italian cheese, bro.
Do it on the side here and kind of just grate it, but that is incorrect. Turn it to the side now, lay it on top, and look at this.
Oh,
much easier. Oh, yes.
It all in the grater itself.
And wow.
Let's say when you're done, boom. That's cool. Simple.
That's sick.
Yo. I'm a sucker for cheese, bro. When you
open
batteries, specifically Duracell, you can actually lock the box back up
okay,
so your batteries
sick.
Don't fall out. It's the most annoying thing. Mostly, and everyone should know.
I always use Duracell batteries. I never knew the box has a... Okay.
Have a little flap here, right? So you kind of
has a lock?
Down. So we have the flap open. I'm going to fold it down kind of like this. So here, let me take a battery out real quick. Okay? I'm done using the batteries now. You fold the top part, and you just tuck
bro.
It inside there. And
bro,
put that
come on now.
Boom.
Bro!
Simple origami, baby.
And I think that was what it was meant for.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I already know you've been tying your trash bags wrong the whole time.
Okay.
Look at this. Some people just do it like this and they just take it out, right? You see
yeah.
the extra space right there?
There's a lot of it.
The right way to do it, you grab it like this, put this around right here, put it in a knot, right?
Okay.
Tie it.
Okay.
Oh, no space. That's the proper way of doing it.
Okay.
You see inside my trash can?
I do. There's more rolls in there.
There's more rolls of trash bags. And another thing people like to do is keep that at the bottom. So when you're done taking out the trash, it's already there.
You don't have to go anywhere else.
Right now, I could just put the new trash
that's
bag
cool.
in without
yeah.
going to the cabinet, grabbing another one. It's cool, but at the same time, like, it does take space away
it
from
does.
The trash.
It does.
You know?
That's why we don't. That's why we don't utilize it. Because I've seen that this hack that we don't really utilize it for that reason.
Yeah. Alright. Simple. So when you have a gift bag like this with the laces in
sorry, guys.
Alright. Simple. So when you have a gift bag like this with the laces in them, you can actually seal it with these. You know, no one wants to see their gift. They want to be surprised. You
facts.
Don't want anyone peeking in either. You
facts.
Literally just take these laces and you put them through the opposite side, just like that. And you do the same on this side.
That's really right. cool.
And now the satisfying part. Ready?
Yep.
3, 2, 1, go.
That's wow. satisfying.
Like
yes.
That. Now look, literally sealed. You
yeah. No more. No one can peek through the... no one could peek through the bag. You know what I mean? It's crazy.
Dude.
I'm still gonna peek.
Popcorn. So if it's late at night and you want to use a microwave, you know when the microwave goes off, it does the beep, beep, beep. There is certain microwaves that you could turn that off just so you could be more stealth.
Like, wow.
In there. And for this specific microwave, you hear the beeps, right? Just like that. If you hold the number 8,
that's it.
Now wow.
I'm gonna press the popcorn button. Just like that.
Crazy.
It's not gonna take the noise from the microwave away, but it will beep once it's done.
I wonder if our microwave has that same, you know.
So discreet.
There's something feature. Else you've been doing wrong with the popcorn too. So we'll wait for that to pop.
Everything's just wrong today.
Everything is wrong.
It's not gonna be. That's it. Yeah.
Oh, crazy.
You can see that slit at the bottom, right?
Right.
He wants to take all the leftover kernels out.
That makes so much sense.
I hate crunching those.
Bro, same.
Same. Okay,
let's see if this works.
I don't like kernels.
So shake it. There they are.
Wow.
Bro, isn't that nuts?
All these.
I mean, I don't mind kernels, but it's just kind of annoying.
Scary kernels.
Did they actually make that for that, or did people just find it out? Use
no
it
idea.
As a life hack.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Boom.
A lot less kernels, if there even are any left.
That's
bro,
really cool.
One kernel fall.
As a gamer, bro, how do you eat these? Because I have a method.
Okay, what's your method? I put salt on it.
Noah, bro. Okay.
No!
That's my method.
Wait, that's the things you didn't know either.
I guess so.
Yo, this is the most
things you didn't know about Noah.
And you already knew it.
Yep. So, Brian, I know you know this, but recently I went 1 week without my phone. And it was the hardest thing ever. This text right
yep.
here saying, everyone's seen this, should have a great day, because you should. If you want
you
to edit this without having to, you know, like, go in between the words and do all
I hate that. Or, like, pressing down on the screen.
Yeah.
Is that a hack? Like, you press down and
move. No. You go all the way to the end and you hold space.
No.
And now.
Crazy.
Space
I'm gonna utilize that.
You want to edit your text.
That's the best one.
Wait, what?
That's the best
crazy.
One.
Crazy.
Guys, learn something new
crazy.
In this video. Drop a like.
Noah,
hit that
thank you.
Button, and we are out.
Thank you, Brian.
Peace.
Guys, which one was your favorite hack? That's insane. That's insane. We learned a lot today. Today was a freaking life lesson video, bro. It's like Face Rug was our Face Rug and Simplistic were our teachers and we were the students. We learned a lot, didn't we? Yes, we did. Let me know which one of these hacks was your favorite. Personally, bro, I loved all of them. That text one at the end was like, oh my gosh, I'm utilizing that, bro. I'm utilizing that, bro. You don't realize how many times I have to edit and stuff, you know, my social media and all that stuff, bro. Oh my gosh, I'm using that editing one for sure. But all these hacks were amazing. You know, it was so cool. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Stay positive. Have a good day. And thank you for the support. Road to 600 subscribers. If you guys want to help me out, definitely leave a subscribe for more banger videos if you guys want to. Take care. Peace.